Hey there, it's B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Whew. I've been hiking up this mountain all day, and the views are spectacular. But wow, it's hard to breathe up here. The air sure feels a little thin. Any idea why that is? It has to do with air pressure and density, which arise from the behavior of fluids. But what are fluids, and why do they behave in such a way that I can't catch my breath on top of a mountain? Whew, that's the question we'll answer in today's lesson. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to identify examples of fluids, compare the density of fluids to solids, define pressure, and explain how it relates to density. What exactly is a fluid? Well, a fluid can be a liquid, like the water in a river, or a gas, like the air we breathe. These two states of matter flow and adapt to the shape of their containers. It helps to remember that fluids can flow, meaning their atoms have more freedom to move around. Solids are not fluids because the rigid structure of their atoms forces them to hold a constant shape. When studying fluids, we'll often consider their density. Do you remember studying density earlier in the course? Density tells us how tightly packed the particles of a substance are. Which state of matter tends to have the highest density? Solid, liquid, or gas? For most substances, the solid form is the most dense. Interestingly, however, water is an exception to this rule, with liquid water being more dense than solid water, or ice. That's why ice floats to the top of your glass. In our next lesson, we'll consider in more depth how density relates to sinking and floating within fluids. When fluids are more dense, the molecules are far more likely to bump into each other than when they are less dense and spread out. Because of this, the density of fluids is directly proportional to another property that we can measure, pressure. Some fluids, specifically gases, can be compressed. This means that it is possible to force their atoms to move closer together and become more dense. Gases tend to have low density, with their molecules staying far apart from one another. But unlike other states of matter, it is possible to force their molecules into a smaller space, where they have to get a little cozier with each other than they might prefer. This creates a higher pressure in the gas. Pressure is any physical force that is exerted on an object through contact. Think of when you open a shaken soda can, that explosive fizz. It's because gases, such as carbon dioxide, can be compressed while in the can, but will then naturally expand rapidly when the pressure is released. Liquids like ocean water can't easily be compressed under pressure like this, but all fluids, including liquids, can exert pressure on objects submerged in them. As this sea turtle swims underwater, the water puts a force on the turtle from every direction, all at once. These combined forces are what is known as fluid pressure. Even gases, such as air, can exert pressure on objects that they surround. This balloon, for example, is experiencing pressure from the air molecules surrounding it. What would happen if we took the balloon to a higher elevation, where the air molecules were farther apart and exerted less pressure? With less pressure on the outside of the balloon, it would swell and become larger. At a molecular level, what do you think causes fluid pressure? Fluid pressure, at its core, arises from the constant chaotic motion of fluid molecules. Within a fluid, molecules are in constant motion. As they move, they collide with each other and with the walls of any container or surface they're in contact with. Every time a molecule collides with a surface, it exerts a tiny force on that surface. Even though the force from a single collision is minuscule, the sheer number of collisions occurring simultaneously results in a noticeable cumulative force. This is what we recognize as fluid pressure. The collective result of billions upon billions of molecular collisions against a surface. In a column of fluid, such as air in our atmosphere or water in an ocean, molecules at greater depths or lower altitudes have more molecules above them. This weight pushing down increases the density of the molecules below and means that objects or organisms at lower depths and altitudes experience more collisions due to the increased density and weight of those extra molecules pressing down. This results in an increased pressure. This is why it's easier to breathe at sea level than on top of a mountain. More air pressure means a higher density of oxygen molecules. But it's also why fish that live in the deep, dark ocean must have special adaptations for dealing with the immense amount of pressure exerted on them. Humans definitely couldn't survive with hundreds of pounds of weight pushing down on us. So, now we know why it's so hard to breathe up here. The air is less dense with oxygen molecules because there isn't as much pressure bearing down on them from above. The air molecules out here might like the extra room to move around, but it means that each breath I take in has fewer oxygen molecules in it. So my lungs are really not a fan. As we went through the lesson today, we saw that fluids can be any liquid or gas, and that one of the most important properties of fluids is their density. The density of a fluid is directly proportional to the pressure it exerts on objects submerged in it. Having a high pressure of oxygen in the air makes it easier to breathe, though being surrounded by a high pressure of water would likely crush us. In the next lesson, we'll consider the question of sinking or floating. We can use density to predict whether an object sinks or floats, or we can calculate the actual forces exerted from the pressure of the fluid. These forces are known as buoyancy, and you may have heard of the ancient Greek scientist who discovered much of what we know about buoyancy, Archimedes. We'll see what he had to say next time. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey.